Welcome to our Conscious Leader Circle, where we meet once a month to support each other through these epic and changing times so we can be more grounded, energized, and focused, or as I like to say, centered, connected, and conscious. And today we have an amazing conscious leader joining us, Joyce Benning, who's going to unlock the magic of a robust lifestyle. This is so exciting. Joyce Benning is the host of her own incredible Robust Lifestyles podcast on the Divas That Care Network. She is a born, bred, and raised country girl who has a passion for animals and a natural approach to inspiring women to live a robust lifestyle. And we can include men in that too, for who are joining us, watching us. I have been honored to be a guest on Joyce's amazing podcast, and we've been talking about the divinity of horses and our own self-empowerment, and grateful that the horses and the horse spirits have brought Joyce and I together. So Joyce will be sharing her personal journey of how she adds magic into living a robust lifestyle, and she'll be sharing tips and ideas that will invigorate your life. So welcome, Joyce Benning.
Well, thank you, Lidia, and it's an honor to be here, and I want to thank each one of you for joining us today, because it is very special. And as Lidia said, I am a born-bred country girl. That's where my life is, and that's why I'm outside doing this, because that's where my comfort is being outdoors in nature, and it is just beautiful here in I'm in central Kansas, and the trees are turning color, and it is beautiful out here. And yes, I do have my own podcast. It's a global podcast. We, through Divas That Care, we reach over 30-some countries, and we're heard all around the universe. So I love it. I've been doing it about 3 years, and magic really starts to come in when you really start to meet other people and touch other people's lives like that. And I always say, if my podcast reaches one person and helps to change their life, every word was worth it and every moment. So that I love doing it. I came up with the name on Robust Lifestyles because robust is strong, healthy, vigorous, and just full of energy. And I just love that, because that's the kind of lifestyle I'm living and I want to live. And the angels and the spirits are what guide me through every day to bring the magic into my life. I have one very special angel. His name is Groucho. He was my little red healer. He came to me in 2011, and I've always been more comfortable with animals than I am anywhere. Animals have touched my heart all my life. And when I met him as a puppy, there was just a bond between us immediately. And he came into my life when he was 6 months old. And oh my goodness, he'd been in my life because I got to see him all the time. But when he came to live with me at 6 months old, it was magical. And I never realized how much he was bringing into my life. I knew he was my soulmate, and I knew he was teaching me. And he taught me how to live with faith and not fear is one of the big things that he was very much at. He had a lot of challenges in his little life, and he was just always right there for everybody. And it was just phenomenal. I started with Divas That Care on my Robust Lifestyle in 2020 is when I started with Divas That Care and having my own show. And little did I know how much Groucho had arranged all of that. The animals are just incredible on what they do for us people and to start to bring the magic into our world. And he arranged a lot of different people to come into my life through Divas That Care and to help me to grow more spiritually and to see the magic that was coming into my life. And my horses, they have played such a huge part in it too. They, just like they told me this morning, it's all going to be good. We have all the faith in the world in you. You're going to do you're going to be fine on this show because we're guiding you and the angels and the spirits are guiding you in every way. And it's just, that's how I bring magic into my life. And in 2022, my little Groucho crossed over the Rainbow Bridge, and I never thought I could live a day without him. But I don't live a day without him because he is right there with me all the time. Within 5 minutes of him crossing, he came to me and he said, "I can run, I can breathe. I love you, Mommy. Don't cry." And it was like, oh my goodness, here he is. And ever since that moment, him and I, we converse all the time. He's right here with me right now. When Lidia asked me to be the speaker, I said, yeah. I asked Groucho and he says, yep, we're going to do this, Mom. I'm right here with you. And we will share on how we bring magic into the world. And it is just amazing how when you turn your focus into thinking of positives. This past week, I interviewed a lady on Robust Lifestyles that she's about helping you to live a better life. And she was talking about how your thoughts change, your thoughts make your reality. And I'm like, oh my goodness, how true that is. And then I listened to another podcast and it was the same thing. And Groucho's going, yeah, Mom, thoughts totally make your reality. And when you start to think the positive in this world and find the positive in things, it's just amazing how your whole world starts to change. And that's how you start to see the magic, is by looking at the positives in people, in animals, in the surroundings around you, in just everything. And the angels and the spirits are always right there. They're right there guiding you. It's like my horse spirit herds came into my life after Groucho crossed. I realized them and I said, where have you been? And they said, we've always been right here with you. You just didn't realize it. And I'm like, oh my goodness. So the magic is just right there. And my horses have taught me so much to live in the present moment. Us humans get so caught up in all the to-do lists and all of our agendas and everything that we've got to do to keep the world flowing. And we just get so caught up in it that I feel I personally forget to live in that present moment and enjoy the moments that are all around me and all the beauty and the magic that surrounds me. It's just something, a sign. And I always say, look for the signs, because the angels leave you so many signs. Groucho's big one is feathers. We find feathers all the time, and he's always giving me meanings to feathers. And he'll sometimes, yesterday we found a beautiful little white feather, and he says, there's angel magic around you. And I'm like, oh my goodness, how true that is. And when you just, I say it's, you live from the heart. You have to let go of that ego mind that we can get caught up in. And I do too at times. And then you have to go back and just live from your heart. And then you start to see the magic that totally surrounds you. And the angels are right there. All you have to do, they're right there. And especially when you ask, if you ask them for guidance, if you ask them, and be sure you thank them. They appreciate the thank yous just as much as your animals do, as us humans do. I see it so much. And even the nature, the trees, just see the magic in them and they'll speak to you too. I mean, I hug the trees and thank them for being there, for the shade they provide. And they, so many times they've said, well, thank you. So many times we don't get appreciated for what we do. And I'm like, it's just magical to hear all of that. And my horses have always said too, to listen in the silence, just turn everything off. And just, I'm outside where I love to be. And that's where I can really listen in the silence and hear the birds singing and hear nature talking to you and hear the trees with the wind blowing. And those are some of the ways that I incorporate magic into my life. And I always ask the angels and the spirits for their help. I have so many examples where they're right there helping us in every way. I had an instance here last June. My other two dogs crossed also. So within a year's time, all three of my dogs had crossed over. And I was having a pretty rough day. And I went outside and went for a walk. And I found the most beautiful feather down in the sand and the dirt. And Groucho goes, underneath the hurt and pain, there is so much beauty. And I thought, oh my goodness, how true that is, because the feather was so beautiful. But yet I was hurting so inside because I was missing my two. And they were right there with me too. They talked to me right away too. And it is just amazing when you, I say you simplify things, just make life simple and just enjoy the pleasures that are so around you, from the animals, from nature, from our angels, from our spirit guides, spirit herds, whatever you want to call them. And how Groucho has helped me in so many different ways. He said before he could cross, he told me that I had to make sure that I could communicate with you. And he said, that's why I have brought all these amazing different individuals into your life to help you to further on your spiritual journey. And I'm like, oh my goodness, how true that is. And he's just been amazing in so many different ways. I feel so connected to him. He's my soulmate. He was here on earth and he is now. And I actually have another little red healer that came into my life 2 months ago. And Groucho and I had been talking about this a lot, because when my female crossed this past in June, she told me she, on Mother's Day, she had some health challenges, and her and I had a long talk, and she said, I'm coming back, and I'm going to come back more vibrant than ever. But she said, will you please let me live out my life, because I need to learn to trust. And I said, yes, I will do everything you need. And she was the kind of dog that I'd had her 17 years, and she would never let you pick her up. She just didn't trust. And with her health challenges, she had to learn to trust me in every way to help her do everything. And she was so grateful. And when she crossed, she said, we're going to find that little red healer for you, and I'm coming back. And I asked Groucho, I said, how will I know? And he said, you will know. And I had many different dogs, many different people try to ask me if I would like this one as my partner. And I didn't have the feeling. And then I saw this post with some healers on it. And I asked the gentleman to please send me a picture of the little red healer's face. And when he sent it, I literally broke out in tears. I got the chills. And I said, that's the one. And Groucho said, that's it, Mom. She's your one. And oh my goodness, she is truly the one. And it's been incredible. So if you just listen to the feelings inside of you, like starting to cry and the chills, and some people say their heart races, and just different ways, and you will feel those angels and spirits. And to me, that is the magic. All of that just brings in to making life magical for you, for everyone around you, because you're feeling the magic in your life, and you make it a robust lifestyle that way. And just like I said earlier, just call on them, ask them for their help, ask them for their assistance. I can give another example that just happened here in the last month. We needed to bring some cattle out of a pasture. We run cattle here. We have mama cows and baby calves, and there's more magic there. Every time I see a new baby calf, it's just magical. I'm like, oh my goodness, look at the magic in that baby calf, how they're running around and jumping and just enjoying life, and in the birds when they're singing, and just everything. But back to when we were going to bring the cattle home, we had one that she was getting close to having a baby calf. And we tried her twice, and she would not get in the trailer. She had no desire to load up in the trailer. So I said, Missy was my little girl's name that crossed in June of this year. And she was a great little cattle dog. I mean, she knew what to do. And I said, Missy, we need your help. I really need you to come and help us get this cow in the trailer. And it was totally amazing because we backed up there the third time and that cow literally walked right in the trailer. And I said, oh, Missy, thank you so much. And I started crying because I knew that Missy was right there. She helped load that cow. And so it's just amazing. And it's magic. It's just magic to feel that when you know that they're right there beside you, they're helping you. And I thanked her so much. And she was happy as could be. She said, I'm here to help you in every way. And that's just one instance. There are so many experiences where they come into our lives and they're always right there. When I get in a vehicle to go somewhere, I'll always say, okay, who's riding with me today? Or where are my spirit herds today? How are they? Which side of the trucks are they riding on? And we just have a conversation back and forth. And to me, that's what puts the magic into life, is just really on that spiritual journey of connecting with them in a way, because they are all around you. They never leave you. They're always right there beside you. Even when your busy mind and your, I call it the 3D world mind, starts to take over and you're like, oh my goodness, where are they? And you just step back and start to go back to your heart, and they're right there to help you in every way. So those are a lot of the ways that I have brought magic into a robust lifestyle. And through Divas That Care, it's just been amazing how many people have come into my life, like Lidia, and just started helping me on the spiritual journey. And every person comes into my life like that, I learned something new from them. And I'm like, there's the magic in it. There's the magic that they were brought into my life for, to help me even bring more magic to others and to live that robust lifestyle. So those are some of the ideas and the tips and ideas that and tools that I use to bring the magic all into my life. And I would love to hear from some of you how you all bring magic into your life and how you connect, because to me, we're all on this spiritual journey together, and helping one another is what it's all about. Helping the animals, helping each other to make this world a better place. And that's what Divas That Care is. It's a community working together to make the world a better place. And it's an incredible journey. So I'm open to questions if anybody has them. I know this wasn't real long, but like Groucho said, keep it simple. And so I did. I just talked from my heart and shared with you how I'm putting magic into a robust lifestyle.
Well, that was magnificent, Joyce. Thank you so much. And I was taking some notes because there were so many things that you shared that we can think about to connect with. One of them was living with the faith and not fear. Mm-hmm. And so the thing that I love about the what we call magic is that we're always feel connected and never alone. And we create the joy, like we feel the joy despite the circumstances of life, because first and foremost, we're spiritual beings. And so to be spiritually connected and to live in that vibration in the midst of difficulties and hardships and the big paradigm shift that we're in, and, you know, all the mundane details that we have to do, is part of our journey of self-mastery. And here you are reminding us that each of us, without exception, has magic in our lives. And when we bring that magic back in, there's a richness of connection and guidance, you know, guidance. So anybody want to ask Joyce any questions or share, as she was saying, your experience with living with magic in your life, or if you'd like to learn more about how to do it and ask Joyce, or anybody here want to contribute? Susanna?
Yeah, first of all, I wanted to say thank you. This resonated a lot with me, all you said, essentially. And I even got a bit emotional in between. I have to put this hand down, right? Yeah. So when you were talking about, you know, your dog's passing and you being in touch because we just lost my father in January, and I've been a bit in touch with him after that, but it's not, you know, it's not something I can, I can't sustain that. I haven't sustained that in kind of a constant way. So that's something I would like to build. My question would be about this aspect that you say you are constantly in touch with your soulmate, and you can hear him and receive messages from him and so on. If you would share a bit more about how you are doing that, in what state you are in, and when you get this connection, or do you have it permanent? So that would be my question here.
Sure. I'm glad to share it with you, and that thank you so much for the kind words. I'm glad it all resonated with you, Susanna. That's awesome. There are times too where, like I said, it's going, I think it's went more when we go into our minds and not living from our hearts is when we have trouble hearing them. I know we have to keep everything going in this world, and we get so wrapped up that then I have to take a step back, and going out in nature is where I can reconnect. Just taking that time and saying, okay, Groucho, why am I not hearing you right at this moment? And he's like, okay, I'm right here. You're not hearing me because there's so much busyness going on in your life. Just kind of step back and go wherever you feel that you can connect. Some people, it may be just, some it's going outside. Some it may be just sitting down and relaxing and just having a cup of coffee, maybe unwinding and just letting it all flow. And just ask them, what do I need to do? What is the message? I ask this a lot. What is the message that I need to hear today to help me to bring the robust into my life? Or what can I do for you? You're always helping me, angels and spirits. What do I need to be doing that can help you to stay more connected to me? Because I know you're always right there beside me. And just going from the heart, I really feel, is the biggest connection. And when you talk about your dad, I can relate to that totally too, because I lost my dad clear back in 1984. And it has just actually been in the last 2 years that I have connected with him on the other side. I would have dreams, but I didn't feel I was connecting with him like I do now. And a lot of times my place to go is out in the pasture, out with the trees and by a creek. And I'll just say, Dad, I'm missing you so much. Can you share a hug with me? And I can feel it. I just feel the hugs coming from him. And it's so cute because Groucho always goes, I'm getting squished because I'm in between the two of you. And it's just kind of letting go and letting them come in the way you feel most, where you're in your most comfort zone, where you're in, where you can really touch with the spiritual world. And yeah, it is beautiful. And here in the last, in September was kind of a tough month. It just seemed like it was, I don't know, there were just a lot of challenges in life during September, and I felt I wasn't connecting like I needed to. And Groucho says, well, we're all busy helping you, girl. You're just not realizing it because of all life's challenges that are coming at you right now, but we're all right here. And then I'll tell you another thing, look for signs. A red bird is always a sign from my dad. And I felt I hadn't connected with him for a while. And would you believe it or not, that morning I saw a red bird. And ever since then, every 2 or 3 days, I will see a red bird. And I go, oh, Dad, thank you so much for connecting with me again. So that's another thing. Dad comes through to me in red birds. That's another sign. So look for the signs sometime of something that is very special to you or something that means so much. So those are some tips. I hope those helped you, Susanna. If you have any questions on them, let me know.
Thank you very much. Just while you were speaking, I thought I just need to a bit more into a meditative state for me to get my mind a bit calmer, let's say, because yes. When I connected with my father, that was usually in kind of a meditative state, and that's exactly what I got was hugs. That's I couldn't communicate, you know, in the way that we have a kind of a conversation or anything, but I could feel him. I'm more yeah. It's easier for me to feel things, and that's what I got from him. What was that he hugged me? Yeah.
Oh, I love that. I love that. And we all have different clairabilities, so not everybody does hear them. And feeling is definitely one of them. Just feeling him near you. So that is awesome. And yeah, just being in that meditative state. So, I'm so glad. And reach out to me anytime. I'm here to answer it in a simple way, in the way that I have experienced it. And it is a beautiful experience when you connect with the ones that I've crossed over. And my dad and I were very, very close. So yeah, I totally can understand.
Thank you.
You are so welcome.
One thing I wanted to comment while we're on that topic about connecting with loved ones on the other side, whether they're from our human family or animal family, my experience, and I've been on the other side lots of times, and I have ongoing dreams and metaphysical experiences with spirits, is that they always want you to be happy.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
So even though grief is a tough taskmaster and we miss them and we grieve that their physical presence is gone, it makes them happy. It makes them feel good. And Vivian's word vibrant on vibrant. When they see us happy or they feel us happy. And I often give the analogy of, let's say if you had to go away and work or something, or go away from let's say your children or family, and you were doing really great, like you were having a good life and loving everything, and you look back and they were sad and mm-hmm. and they were missing you and not feeling your presence of joy. And so we all grieve, and it's very difficult. And I know all about that. And there's no right or wrong way to do that. But I always come back to that awareness that it's okay for me to feel happy and joyful, even though I'm still missing, the person or animal on the other side, because that it makes them happy to feel my joy. So I just wanted to share my experience with that. Anybody have anything they want to discuss on this beautiful topic? Vivian?
I also see that Jasna has unmuted. So Jasna, did you want to say something first?
Hello, everyone. Can you hear me?
Yes. Yeah, because I noticed you unmuted. So I'll wait for you.
It's okay now. I think so. Okay. Brief introduction. I'm relatively new to LinkedIn, where I found information about you, Lidia, and your work. So this is first time for me to join this group.
Welcome.
This session. And I must tell you that I haven't prepared at all for this discussion. But you know what? This is a part of a challenge. How to show up without being prepared. And that's exactly a message that I'm sending to my clients, since I'm a coach and a hypnotherapist. How can you show up, for example, next week, without being prepared? Just showing who you really are. Okay? I love this topic. I love this topic about how to ground ourselves in the time of uncertainty. And as we all know, there are a few things human beings are afraid as much as they are afraid of change. I think this is true, really. And I think that we all globally live in a time of a massive changes that affects almost all aspects of our lives, but especially human consciousness. So I think we live in a particular moment, which is known as evolution of human consciousness. So what I'm interested in is actually how are we ready to embrace change, whatever it means, and what's our unique way to do that without being fearful or scared or whatever. Okay. Now, for example, the artificial intelligence is a big issue of nowadays. Should we be scared or interesting to figure out what that whole thing is actually about? How can we benefit? Is the future of mankind actually to develop emotional and social intelligence, because artificial intelligence will actually replace most of our cognitive functions, right? So developing of emotional and social intelligence is going to be the fundamental of human development in the future. Okay, I mentioned so many things. by the way, I love everything that Joyce shared about how to stay in touch or make connections with our loved ones. If I have just a minute or less than a minute, I can share with you, Joyce, something interesting, a dream that I had a couple of years ago. It was somewhere around COVID era. And I was always very close to my late grandmother. And I consider her to be my guardian, right? And there was a dream where it was me in that dream. It was her. She approached me. She gave me a hug. I remember that I asked her, how is it possible that you are here? You are dead. But she replied, oh yeah, I died, but I visited the rest of you to see how are you doing. And I mentioned that dream to my mom, okay? My mom said, well, it's interesting. Our cousin of my grandmother and my mom, he had a very similar dream. I decided to call him on phone and I asked him what your dream was about. He said, and that's important. In my dream, there was me, my grandmother, and that man. In his dream, there was me, my grandmother, and him. He said she approached him. She gave him a hug, and she started crying. In my dream, she was smiling. So it was quite interesting. That man and I were not in touch for a long time. He was in my dream, I was in his dream, and my grandmother was with both of us. So I'm not sure how to understand that dream. Was that a message? Was that kind of warning? was that an invitation for two of us to connect and discuss something. So, Joyce, what's your opinion about that? If you have any opinion.
Well, what came to my mind right away when you said that is your grandmother had seen special, we all have special and unique qualities, but she saw the qualities in you and him that you maybe weren't letting your light shine yet. You were maybe, you have that unique talent that you haven't, you maybe have realized it, but maybe it's kind of buried down inside because you're not sure what others will say if you let that light shine. And this is what came to me, is she saw that quality in both of you. And she's like, you guys need to let your light shine. Each one of you has so much to give to the universe and so much to share. And that's why she came to you, and each one of you had each other in the dream. And that's just kind of something that the angels kind of came to me as you were talking and said that that is it. Because just real quick, my horses in a lot of readings have said, you need to let your light shine. And my dad has said that to me, you got to let your light shine. And that is what I am getting for you. Now that you can kind of take that and just think about it. I mean, what light would you like to let shine out to this world that can help others in so many ways, and that you maybe you have it on dim right now, and it's time to really let that light shine. And your grandmother is now on the other side, and she's right there to help you to let that light shine. So that was my thoughts on it, Jasna.
Thank you, Joyce. Thank you very much. Okay, that's much for me. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Well, thank you. Welcome to our community. Is it Jasna? How do you say your first name?
Jasna. It's actually Jasna.
Jasna. I wasn't sure if it was a silent J. Mm-hmm. But that was beautiful sharing. Thank you. And yes, we're all here to figure out how to stay centered, connected, and conscious as we navigate through these epic times. And we're all here to support each other. Vivian.
Hi. Hello, everybody. And hello, those people that I haven't met yet. So I want to say a couple of things. First of all, there was a message to me, and I don't know where it came from, that I had to come on to Lidia's Connected Conscious Leaders today. And yet my entire, like, today was planned, like at 9 and at 10, and I had calls here and there and everywhere. And I somehow woke up this morning, because I registered this morning, and I didn't even know who was going to be on. I had a feeling I needed to be here today. And I moved everything and shifted everything around in order to be here for my time, 11. Anyway, and Joyce, my gut instinct and my feeling of wanting to be here with the group today was correct, because I needed to hear, well, I didn't need, I enjoyed so much hearing what you had to say. And I felt in such alignment with you and your, you know, just you're very, very brief. It wasn't, we didn't have enough time with you, but your comments and just your beautiful lifestyle and what you had to say. And it meant a lot to me to hear you. So thank you for that, first of all. And I did want to say, so I totally align with you. It's interesting because, as Lidia knows, I wrote a book called Go Vibrant, and it's notes and anecdotes on loving and living the joie de vivre. And it's really the same thing, like living that robust lifestyle and intentionally living it, not just waiting for it to happen, right? Intentionally finding the path that takes you out of the grunge and the challenges and everything, because they're always going to be there in life. So I immediately, like, I'm a kindred spirit of yours immediately. I do have a connection that I made long, long time ago. My dad passed away very young at the age of 71 in 1987. And I was extremely close to him. We just were, like, connected like this. And he was a man of few words, but many emotions and many, I mean, his love was just always there for me. And he understood me. I was kind of a different teenager and a different youth, and like I just was a little different. And he just totally understood me, his artsiness, his creativity, etc. And he has come to me forever in the sign of a butterfly. And sometimes these butterfly messenger, whether it's a messenger or if it's my dad personally, has come to me at odd times. Like I was born in Portugal and we were in Portugal celebrating my birthday, and it wasn't even butterfly season. And this beautiful butterfly flew by while I was reading a card from my mother, who was with me, and my dad was no longer with me. And I was reading the card, and in the card it said, your dad would feel so good to know you were in Portugal, your birthplace, celebrating your 65th birthday or whatever it was, 61st. And that the butterfly flew by, and my husband was taking pictures at the time, and it's in the picture with me reading the card. So if I needed any, like my sister was not a believer in any of this, and she was there, and she went, okay, you're making me a believer. Because, and that butterfly comes to me, or a host of butterflies comes to me when I'm feeling sad, when I'm overjoyed, when I'm celebrating, like many, many different times in my life. Now, I was very interested in what you were saying, and Susanna, what you were also conscious of the fact that I haven't really had a conversation, but I feel I've had, like, I feel that somehow I have received the message and know where I am at the time and know what I needed to hear. I didn't hear words like mm-hmm. you sweet little grouch and so forth. But what was I going to say? I wrote it down and now I forget. Yeah, I feel that the thoughts were transmitted to my intentions of the day or the month or the challenges. Like I sort of what you said something, you know, ask your spirits and angels, what do I need to do? And though I don't hear my dad's voice, I feel his presence. I sometimes smell his smell. With me, but it automatically puts me in a different track. I'm a very mm-hmm. emotional person. I'm an empath. I'm a person who feels a lot of feelings and sometimes gets very upset with other people. And I have high expectations of people. And you know, and I am very perceptive of people. Sometimes people like you and I, Joyce and Susanna, who have this, and Jasna with your wonderful talk today. Sometimes other people get a little bit intimidated or scared by, well, I'm going to talk about me. They get scared by me or I'm too much for them with all of this that I have around me. And sometimes I, you know, don't have the best of thoughts from them to me, to other people, but I know them. Like I know what's going on. And those are moments that my dad is always there for me, saying like, and I realize, you know, this isn't about me, this is about them. Like, move on, re-challenge yourself to where you're going, go back to your path of what you're meant to do, and that kind of thing. So I just love this. This was wonderful. Mm-hmm. Just reconnects me again to know that I'm on the right path and doing the things I need to do for me and for the world, like a big service to the world out there where I'm needed to be. So thank you, Joyce. I love this. Thank you, Lidia, for bringing Joyce to our group.
Thank you, Vivian. That was so beautiful and heartfelt and honest and sincere. And that's what this group is all about, is to have an honest sharing and to support each other and to be able to speak our truth and not feel alone, you know, on our journey. And here we are from all parts of the world coming together. And did Joyce drop? Her signal must have dropped. I was just about to go to Joyce.
I see her in the middle with the mute. So maybe she got a call or somebody's talking to her. She's still on.
Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Can you hear me, Lydia?
Because,
okay. Went out and then it came back on again. So I don't know what that was all about. It happens. Thank you so much, Vivian, for all those kind words. That was beautiful. Thank you. I'm so glad.
Oh, we've lost Joyce. She'll come back in again. Jasna, did you have something else you wanted to share with us?
Just a brief feedback to what Vivian just shared. Vivian, you said that you have impression that you are too much, right? Somehow too much. Okay, just a suggestion for you, because I have the same parent. I'm too much. On the flip side, I'm not enough. It's always not enough and too much, right? Well, we always should take care about what is our reference point when we think about ourselves as being too much. Is it possible that your environment is too small? Not that you are too much. But those who are surrounded with are too, yeah. And working with my clients in coaching, what I found out that it is a sad story behind someone's perception that he or she is too much. People who have perception of themselves like you, like me, that they are too much, okay? And they also have experience that they somehow dominate the room, right? Or they steal the show. But what's behind? They just, Vivian, I mean, we just haven't learned how to articulate our almost childish need to share, to communicate. Since we haven't learned that, we show up as too much. Oh, it's me who wants to dominate. It's not true. It's just how to learn to share with other people, okay? To show up being authentic without fear of being misinterpreted or misunderstood that much. I just wanted to share that with Vivian, because I have the same thing, same perception of myself. I'm too much, oh my God. And people around me will notice that.
Well, thank you, Jasna. And living in our own truth is living in our power. And so it's important for us to show up as who we are. And often those of us who have that, who haven't lost our connection to our essence and our power, are, let's say, on our soul path, we're meant to be in groups of people outside in the world, as aside from our group, but that need our activation. And we don't do it intentionally. So I know on my journey, I've reflected, I know in self-development, they often say, well, the people around you are a reflection of you. And I'm like, oh, I love the people around me. But then I began to realize that sometimes, because we're strong and we've stayed connected, that we're meant to go to places and be in groups and environments where we just need to show up. And by doing so, we help shift that energy. And it's not so much that the environment is a reflection of me all the time. It's sometimes that I'm meant to go in there to help create change or to shift the frequency. And the reference that I give to this for those people who are maybe watching, or anyone here who are connected with animals, is sometimes I ask, well, why do horses incarnate in the darkest of places? Why do they incarnate with people who abuse them and send them to be slaughtered? And after much reflection, it's not those, the people around them aren't reflecting who the horse is, right? The horse is there to raise the vibration and to help awaken the heart and the spiritual connection of the humans in that world. And they're the strongest of the strong. We are the strongest of the strong. Not that we're better at all, but that we haven't lost that connection and we are powerful enough to stay in our center and to radiate our light. And if people feel uncomfortable with that, that's what's meant to happen, because that's who we're meant to connect with. Does that make sense?
Oh, yeah.
It's a bit of a different perspective. Bye, Susanna. Thank you for joining us. Then I like to look at some of the teachings in self-development and take a broader perspective and a deeper understanding, because they may apply at certain times in our lives and in with some people's sort of imprints and dynamics, but they're not always applicable, you know. And I've been called on quests to go to places that I had no interest in being. And it wasn't because they were reflecting back on me. It's because I was meant to go there to help create change, not from ego, but from essence. And that's what happened when I was asked to run for mayor of Ajax. It was like a huge, no, I'm not going to do that. And then I understood, you know, from a more Taoist on attachment type of experience. But this is a really wonderful, deep, insightful conversation. It all comes back to Joyce's magic, and that when we feel connected to ourselves, then we feel comfortable in creating magic, right? It's and we don't want to, you know, as Jasna was saying, and we're talking about with Vivian sharing, as powerful spiritual beings, we never want to dim our light. We're meant to shine the light so that, yes, Martin, you can chime in. And we're meant to sometimes make people feel uncomfortable, because sometimes there needs to be, this is a time of great awakening. And how are people going to shift into their greatest selves if sometimes they're not uncomfortable, right? It's the old expression, you know, what is it? You grow beyond your comfort zone or something. So sometimes that's our journey, not to be an antagonist, but to be present and non-attached, right? To how people are perceiving us. And if they stick around, they stick around. If they don't, they don't. But that's not nothing to do with us, right? Martin.
Hi, everybody. And I just wanted to actually respond to what Lidia and, well, everyone was saying similar. Just thinking back to what it was like socially during COVID. So for me, it's like, I kind of miss humans, to being around humans, being in a group of people in one room. And that's like you're saying, Lidia, that is normal. We're supposed to be with other people. We're not supposed to be working on our own all day, all night, living, you know, we're social. And like, sorry, what Joyce was saying, making connections when you're happy and you're sad and just being in the moment. And the hardest thing for us is the ego telling us what to do. The ego says, do this, do that. Judge yourself. And yeah, it's a difficult thing when you have to confront the ego and say, no, I'm gonna do what I feel is right, and not listen to the ego and just go to that point where, yes, this is where my happy space is. And if you're not listening, if you're not interested or you're not receptive, I'll go to a community or a group that is. And like, one of the questions I was going to ask Joyce, because obviously I know the answer, was why did you start your podcast? It's because you felt, I think you felt, this was a way to communicate and join others and support the belief systems that you have and spread it. And more and more and more. And this is what we need, I think.
Well, I started my podcast because Candace Gish is the founder of Divas That Care Network, and she believed in me. I never dreamed that I could be a host on a global podcast. And she asked me to do it, and she believed in me that I could. And that's all it took. And I know now it was Groucho. He was still with me on Earth then. And I know it was him. He played a big part in it too, because he said, I was aligning everything up for you. So it was the right time. And I had someone that believed in me that I trusted, and it just expanded from there. And I love doing it. I love letting other people shine their light and letting them know what they can do in this world and how they can help others. So that's how I got started with it 3 years ago.
That's beautiful, Joyce. That's beautiful. And how did you connect with Candace?
I had connected with Candace through some networking. I've known her since, about 15 years now. So a long time. So yeah, we got connected that way. And actually it was through her mother that I met her. And she's an amazing woman too. She's always out there to help others. And that's what's so beautiful. And she actually created Divas That Care because she has four daughters, and she wanted her daughters a platform to see where there were other people in this world that were letting their light shine and the good that they were doing for the world. So that's why she created Divas That Care. We've done books. She just had the one was released called Our Mothers, Our Daughters book. In on Mother's Day, it was released this year. And then last year, I believe, or 2 years ago, we did Animal Prints on My Soul, which was a really beautiful book. I actually wrote a story in there about my experience, some of my experiences with animals. And she's done a couple other women's books. They're all little short stories that different authors submit. So that's some of the things she has done with Divas That Care.
Wow. We're guided. We're guided, uh-huh. And we share, and then we let go. And, you know, like Jasna was saying, sometimes it's important to be aware of how to communicate, right, in a certain environment, and of tuning in to who's present, right, and reflecting on how to be more in alignment and how to share who we are. And then sometimes we just show up. We just show up and let her rip, right? And and then we don't want to feel alone when we're in groups or in places where people don't get us. So then we create our own communities so we can talk about these things, right? It can be lonely to, you know, when people don't always resonate, you know, with who you are and how you live. And again, you know, being on my farm, and I have the reference, I rescue horses and then are taken unwanted horses and then have vets and farriers and people come, and not everybody who I interact with on the property is supportive of how I live and what I do. Oh, well, you know, that's so like Jocelyn was saying, you know, we use our discernment. We use our discernment, and but we don't, in the discernment of our communication sharing, we still don't want to dim our light. Right? Because ultimately we're all one, right? We're all one energy field. We're all one consciousness. We're all one love, as Bob Marley or whoever said, start singing the song, right? So whoever feels frustrated or is opposed to who I am, again, I don't think they're always a reflection of my inner work that I need to do, but I honor who they are and I continue on because they're part of me, right? We're all part of each other. And so I don't want to create more resistance. So we have the non-attachment and keep flowing and shining. And that's, imagine if no one was shining their light. I mean, we went through that in the dark ages in medieval times, right? And now we're coming out of that. And we're all starting to feel comfortable with that. This is a process over the next 50 years up to 2100, where we can't have enough people on the planet talking about this, right? Talking about it's okay to be yourself and to shine your light. And if people aren't receptive, we can, as Martin was saying, redirect, or just let it be, you know. Mm-hmm. But it is important at this time, and that's the magic of living, you know, and all the beautiful things that Joyce was sharing. I have so many notes here. Looking for the signs, listening in the silence, focusing on the positives, right? Focusing on the positives and really feeling connected to that guidance, right? That is powerful, that we're really connected and feel value in acting on our guidance, which is magical. It's magical, especially this time of year, when the veil between the material and spiritual worlds is the thinnest, right? And magic is all around us, but so more easily accessible, you know, at this time of year. So I know we've gone over. Anybody else want to share? Teresa on the phone, did you want to share anything?
Okay, I'll make it very brief. As I was listening, the word balance kept coming to me. You know, as an artist, for instance, when I paint, I realized the importance of balance in creating a composition, you know, a beautiful composition where the colors are flowing, the forms are flowing, and art is a communication, as everything is a communication. So as we see, balance is very important. If, for instance, someone, if an artist takes a paintbrush and just puts a lot of paint globs and globs on the canvas, it can be overpowering to the viewer. But if there is balance in the painting, the balance invites the viewer to open up their heart, their soul, and spirit, and communicate with the depth of the painting, of what the artist is trying to communicate, which hopefully is an expression of the heart, the soul, you know, of a larger universal communication. And I'm wondering if the word balance is something that, you know, we can think about in our communication through using words. Like in the interaction of communication with somebody else, but yes, our energy and vibration speak volumes, especially for high frequency energy and vibration beings, you know, connect to our soul. But how we express it is through words is also very important, where keeping in mind perhaps that art is a form, I mean, communication is a form of art, and that when we are interacting with others, we are also interacting with someone else's perceptions, experiences, opinions, their soul and spirit, and perhaps allow in that communication, not maybe loud isn't the right word, but, you know, create a space where others feel comfortable and not overpowered by our being. So create that space of communication where there is a balance between ourselves and to whom, you know, we are communicating.
Yeah, that was beautiful and so well said. And so that's the art of living, right? The art of living is knowing when to pull back and when to go forward, and you know, that discernment and the balance of what, how much to share and how much not to share. And but thank you, Teresa. I mean, balance is the essence of yin and yang, right? It's the essence of the universe. And we can just develop our self-mastery around that, right? And if people still get triggered by us, well, that's why we have no attachment. Can we just stay on our magic? But absolutely, communication is art. That's really magnificent, Teresa. Thank you so much. It's 12:15. Anybody else want to share anything? And anybody who wants to stay for a long distance Reiki sending, you're welcome to. I don't have anyone to do a guided meditation, but we can just do silence if you'd like. Anybody, or what's your time like?
A quick little story that sort of connects to everything.
Sure, yeah, absolutely.
Okay, very quick little story. So my mom passed away 2 years ago, and at 100, almost 101. And she was a very strong, powerful person. And kind of wondered how she was going to come to me, because my dad is always there, as I mentioned. So the other day we had a big event, a family event. We had my family from Portugal over. I had them up for brunch. Everybody was here. And a shelf underneath a counter where I had lots of dishes on, like serving dishes, because I'm in a small condo now, so I have to put everything in different places. The shelf toppled and all dishes on it fell off. And the only serving piece of hers that I thought I had saved, which was a crystal serving piece where you put desserts on, toppled over and crashed and made a big impact. And I didn't, without hesitation, I said, okay, Mom, you're here too. I hear you. We've neglected you. We haven't spoken about you. You're here. I mean, this is beautiful. Now, interesting enough, I had to go to the locker room to get something else. And within that thing I was looking for was another dish I had forgotten that I had saved of hers, which was a crystal. It was the matching plate, like a smaller version. Anyway, so it's like she guided me even to the locker room to say, no, this wasn't the only piece you have from me. You have another piece. So I said, okay, Mom, you're around. I will be paying attention and more conscious to you and not just Dad. So, and that would be my mom's nature too. Like, that's the difference between my dad comes in as a butterfly. My mom comes in as a crashing crystal plate. Anyway, it's just a cute story, but she's around now and I know her. The interesting thing very quickly is very soon after that event, I got asked to be on a panel of a movie that she's in. Like, it was like days later. There's a movie called Lisbon Harbor of Hope. I can send it to you, Lidia. You can pass it out. It's going to be shown as free. It's about Jews who escaped to Portugal from the war and were allowed to come into Portugal with visas, and actually, you know, called Harbor of Hope, because over 3,000 Jewish people were saved there. And my mother at 2020 came in with her family, her mom and dad, met my father who was working there, who had come in the same way, and ended up marrying, and I was born in Portugal. But this lady contacted us to be part of a panel, my sister and I, for this movie that was now showing, which I was looking for. And now it's showing and there's a link to it. And now I can see the movie and I've actually seen it now again. And I'm getting to do a panel, which means I had to go through all these little pictures of her that I've been saving up to try. And there's my dad, like little old pictures. Uh-huh. And so I'm telling her story like more than the movie did. And I'm going to be on a presentation next Sunday on the 29th. So all of these things came together, right, Joyce? Mm-hmm. Together. This is a cute little story. I'm off now. I'd love to do a meditation or whatever you have planned.
Sure. Well, thank you again for sharing all that, Vivian. There's the magic, right? There's the magic in that we're never alone. And we live in a multidimensional world. We can only see a certain spectrum of visible light, but we can feel all dimensions. And that's the magic, right? Of feeling that connected. Any last words, Joyce, about living a magical and robust lifestyle? And I encourage everyone to listen to Joyce's incredible podcast and robust lifestyle show on Divas That Care. And if any of you want to connect, feel free to do so, and I can connect everybody, and we'll keep supporting each other.
Well, thank you all so much for what you've contributed. You've made my day magical, totally magical. And I hope I brought some magic into each one of your days, because it's been a very magical day. And Vivian, I have to just quick add, like what you said with your mother, my Missy dog comes to me through my computer. I'll walk in the house and all the lights are on the computer, just blinking away. And I go, okay, Missy, it's you. Yep. She comes in with a flash, because that was her. Very vibrant. So that was really neat. I thank you for sharing that. But yes, I just want to thank all of you, and you're all welcome to connect with me in any way. And if I can help anyone on their spiritual journey, because we'll just share with each other like we did today. And that's where the magic starts, is just take the time, listen to your angels, listen to your spirit guides, and tell them thank you and ask them for their help. They are very appreciative, and they're always right there beside you. So may each one of you have a very magical day, and the magic be with you always.
Well, thank you, Joyce. That was beautiful. And for people listening, and thank you, Jasna, for joining us. It's a pleasure to meet you. And hopefully you can join us again. And Joyce, do you have an email address or some way that people can connect with you? You can put it in the chat. But for people when I put it on my podcast, is there a best way to connect with you?
Yes, I will go ahead and put my email address out to everyone, and then that way it will be on there. So that would be great. I'd love to connect with each and every one of you.
Okay, thank you.